My name is Tom Sampson. I'm about an hour and a half away from you guys, so definitely appreciate the time everyone here who welcomed us. So I just want to jump into it. We're going to be talking about attitude of gratitude and also the power of choice. Now, the specific story I'm sharing with you is specifically the power of choice. Everyone understands all the sum up of all the decisions and choices we made in our life that led us to where we are now. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. So now we have to kind of think long term. What kind of choices and decisions am I going to make now to benefit me next week, 2 months, 3 months, 5 years from now? When I was in college, I went to college for a semester. I wasn't a huge school guy. I went because my parents told me to. I went to college. I went to Johnson Wales University in Miami, Florida. Now, I remember calling my mom because at this time I wasn't too sure whether I wanted to pursue a school, because at the time, again, me and Steve were going through some really good momentum in the business. That was something I was really passionate about. The kind of things I was learning in school, for personally, for myself, I kind of felt like it wasn't aligning with where I wanted to be. So the point being is I called my mom and I said, hey mom, I'm kind of feeling, I'm not sure about school anymore. Now my mom's traditional, go to school, get good grades, go to college, get a career, retire, whatever. But it really hurt me, because after I had expressed my feelings about college, she says, okay, then be a mom. That really hurt. But I kind of understood where my mom was coming from, because that's all she knew. Go to school, get an education, things like that. But I had the choice at that time to let it discourage me, to not focus on my real dreams and goals that I had for myself. I could have just quit all of that and said, you know what? Sure, I'll follow what my mom wants me to do. But I didn't. I took matters in my own hands, because I understand my life is my life. And with all respect to my mom, there was only one way of thinking for her. So my point being is, when we run into situations like that when we're discouraged, right? Maybe our family members, our close friends might say, well, what you want to do is too risky, or it's not realistic. I hear that too many times. It's not realistic. Where sometimes we have to sit back and think to ourselves, where is it that I actually want to be? I forgot her name, the young lady in the Zumba lady, how she was pointing out, there are going to be people who tell you can't do this, you can't do that, for whatever reason. You have to make a decision whether you're going to let that hold you back, or you're going to look past and understand, I know what I want, and that's what I'm going to go for. But we have to understand and think long term, what kind of choices I'm going to make today that's going to benefit me long term. Because a lot of people